I'm Devon. I'm a game developer, and tonight we are playing through some more XCOM 2 War of the Chosen. So we've got a guerrilla op going on right now, and we have a pretty good number of our high-level soldiers available, including our favorite Bond pair, Diamond and T-Rex. I was actually looking at this a little bit between games, and liking the idea of spending a little training center points and PCS upgrading Christophe Fournier. He's got enough AP that I'm pretty happy picking up heavy ordnance for him to give him an extra grenade slot. And then I also like giving him our aim PCS, which my favorite is putting those on snipers, but our two high-level snipers already have those. And as you get in on the game, it becomes very important to be able to get the shred from your grenadiers. So being able to guarantee those hits is super valuable. And quickly check building items for any other housekeeping before we hop into, yeah, we are very short on supplies right now. We've got a Reaper upgrade available, but our Reaper's on a covert action anyways. Alright, so we are in the middle of a guerrilla ops. Was looking at these a little bit, the hacking a workstation is a little rough because we're short on specialists at the moment. We don't know what this dark event is. Scientist would be pretty good. Wild Hunt, the 75 intel is the lowest reward, but Wild Hunt seems pretty annoying. And then we've got get an engineer to avoid the black market being closed. One upside of this is that we have our Templar available, and the Warlock is vulnerable to the Templar, so if he shows up, that's best. But I think what I'm feeling is going after this one. So we could have the Hunter show up. He is weak to skirmishers and getting attacked a bunch, so that should be fine. The reward is the lowest, but this dark event seems really annoying.
Setting course for Brazil.
Avatar Project is very high, but we do have a covert action going on that'll knock some bars off there.
Our troops equip the Skulljack for use in the field if we're going to make any progress towards our current.
All right, yes, and we do have the Skulljack now. We've also got our plasma grenades. Who's lowest level here? So it's plausible we'll want to bring Andre. Let's use available. So the don't want to bring tire troops. We just got squad size 6. This is our first squad size 6 mission, so that's awesome. Double grenadier, double sniper seems pretty good. This is a sabotage transmitter. There's no lost or anything. We've got really good upgrades between our grenade launchers and our plasma grenades. We're a little short on other utility items. Man, we have so many empty slots right now, it's very embarrassing. We need some supplies to build some more stuff. So we've got really good Ranger, two really good Templar. We do not have any specialist, so we are currently operating completely without a medic. Skulljack is better on a grenadier than on a sniper. B- Bringing double frost bombs seems really good. And then I think I like a flashbang on this sniper better than a plasma grenade. So go ahead and trade out, make weapons available. Don't have any upgraded these? What are the upgrades we have available right now? Advanced scope. Just giving Fournier extra aim would not be bad. Don't have any other weapons for him. She is the correct upgraded weapon. Get weapon upgrades. Alright, so do we wanna... Alright. I think we want a mag cannon with aim more than we want a second sniper rifle with aim, just because this is a bonus for the first of a class on a mission, whereas a second sniper rifle only matters if we're bringing two sharpshooters. Oh, he's also a genius. That's good to know. That makes me a little more glad to be bringing him, even though he's fairly low level. And give the better one with the aim to the rookie. Although, does he have shred? If he does not have shred yet, he does have shred. So I'd rather help the lower level guy get some extra aim than stack more aim on the high level guy. Anything else we want to do before this? This is looking pretty good to me. Rock and roll.
Sky Ranger deployed.
Menace ready to deploy.
Begin mission.
Picking up unusual readings coming from this area, and our recon team has confirmed that Advent is now
operating. This is one of the short timer, but a lot of things to shoot to extend the timer. Shen and Tigan
agree. If we destroy the transmitter
of one of our soldiers
connected to Advent's network, their operations across this entire region.
Also worth noting, we've got the Skulljack here.
Advent has constructed a psionic transmitter in this
area, tied directly into their primary network. We'd really like to get a chance to use that.
Our intel suggests destroying it while it's still connected will severely damage their linked systems. Plant the explosives before they have a chance to pull the plug.
Okay. So there's kind of the outer tunnels, and then this big central area that's kind of sectioned off. Where are we trying to, we are trying to get, geez, all the way over here. So... yeah, let's send the run-and-gun troop up first to, just in case anything goes wrong. We've got two snipers, so we'll stack them up on the back early. We do need to move forward somewhat aggressively, and there's more advantage than usual to covering some extra ground just to see the transmitter nodes. So I'd really rather not get her flanked. But we do need to start making some time here at some point. So you you are a low-level grenadier, let's just take a risk and run you all the way up here. Alright. Cool, so that'll be our first pod to engage. So we can set up on them. So we'll want to get some snipers in good positions.
Time to motor.
We'll probably want to pull our Templar up a little bit.
I trust in your command.
Still no note. Oh, there we've got a note, so we'll be able to shoot that one for the delay shortly. Alright, and second sniper. I think we'll just put you here. A little risky, but put you here.
Getting it done.
This is a little risky if they patrol into us, but it's saving some good time and getting us a good approach on them, even if they do a little patrolliness like this. Not necessarily that much. Here is push up a little ways, shoot this node. If that triggers them immediately, we can deal with that.
Yes, Commander.
And if it
we are closing on the objective,
our readings indicate that relay is
doesn't trigger them, we'll be able to set up some overwatches. We'll pop our cover on these and then set up some overwatches on them.
As we had hoped, the network
so it's actually pretty good to pop our cover there, since we're hoping they patrol into us. So, can't be anything over here, so this is a fairly safe move to keep pushing up. Probably worth spending a shot on... Oh, we don't have a shot on this. That surprises me. Oh, I guess this is blocking. Makes sense. So...
What's over there?
Let's leave Overwatch on her... and pull the other sniper up. We don't want to pull up to where we could potentially set them off. This looks not ideal, but reasonable. And then Overwatch. Overwatch. Alright, so this door is going to be a little bit rough. And we're pushing through to there. So this is the map in which we left. We lost our first troop, Klaus the Rookie, in this little hole. So we can buy a little time, but I don't want to risk it too much. This door is just not a great place to be set up.
If you say so.
So let's not walk directly up to the door this turn. Take one turn off to kind of pull everyone up, since we've got some people who are so far back. This is the riskiest move we're going to make here. did our ranger just moved up this side? So anywhere in here could potentially see the pod through the door. So I do want to push him up a little bit. But not too much. Get to take out this node. Yeah, so we'll just pull everyone up this turn.
Is it clear?
And move towards the door next turn. And if they patrol back into us, we'll have a little bit of Overwatch for them.
Moving to Overwatch.
Moving to Overwatch.
Alright, so you've got a pretty good move up to here, which will probably reveal something. Nothing. So I want to move one of our snipers up to the doorway to get a shot on it, if possible.
Okay, I'll go.
Which could also reveal a pod. There we go. So this should be a pretty safe pod to take out if we don't have any other problems. So you've also got frost bombs. 89. Why are you just out of cover? And we deal 6 to 8, and that is 8 health. So we could just kill that, and then probably finish it off with Lightning Hands. Yep. Actually, you could just kill it yourself. Oh, mutons can counter melee, so we don't necessarily want to try and use our Templar for that. What's your shot? 44? High cover? These don't blow up very easily. We could have someone run upstairs, if anyone can get up there. Could do it with a run and gun, that'd be kind of fun. If we did run and gun, you probably just wanted me to hear. So we can kill the Viper a lot of different ways. It's just the Muton that's a problem. So I think I'm good throwing a Lightning Hands on here just to let that inform our further decision making. And you presumably does this end your turn? Not seeing an ability that says it wouldn't, but I think you're more of our sniper. I'm not really doing anything else this turn, so I think let's just see if this solves our problem without moving any farther forward. And unsurprising, but she wasn't going to do anything more valuable than that. Alright, now let's go ahead and take this 90, verify that we're going to be able to kill the Viper.
Right on the margins!
Also get some holo targeting to try and finish it off here.
Hey, take a look at this. That's it.
Alright, and then you do still have 2 pistol shots left. So you're pretty likely to kill this Muton. We could hit him with a grenade or a shotgun. Just keep using Lightning Hands. Alright, well, let's just see what you do. That shouldn't have ended your turn. Oh, you only had one action left. Never mind. Alright, so we could kill him with a grenade. Probably. Or we could take our Reaper out of cover and risk a second pod. So we shot through the wall, and it activated another pod. After all that.
Moving on target location.
Alright, well, at this point, let's cut our losses. I'm not super happy about that being how things went. Alright. So the pod's pretty concentrated on that side. So she could give him another action, and then he could do some frost bombing or something here. Or do you have the Skulljack? We don't really want a Skulljack against a full pod. So you can move up here and pick up this loot.
Roger
that.
Be
fairly safe. Illyrium Corp. Got another node to shoot.
I've got the thing.
Come get some.
Oof, Mark is not great.
I'm gonna need support here.
Oof. That is a really bad start. Wow. Just kill through high cover.
We'll have to give our soldiers some time to heal, mentally and physically.
Okay, so that was a little bit glitchy.
Cut off the transmitter from their network. We're running out of time.
Man, that sucks. Alright, who's got a Skulljack and can you use it? Oh, don't tell me. Fournier had the Skulljack, of course. Unreal. So that was one of our absolute best characters. Psychic, do you have a rend on... You do. So we would like to shred his armor first. Oof, that is a painful loss. 52. Let's take a moment to mourn Fournier. Crit killed from heavy cover by a pod we discovered by shooting through a wall. Let's grenade this dude instead of taking the risk on the shot. It'll blow up his cover. Destroy his armor.
Grenade!
And allow us to kill these two without moving forward and risk yet more pods. Alright, so we probably need one more shot on here. Might as well just fire your pistol here and finish this guy off.
I got it, right?
Revenge is not as sweet as we might have hoped. Alright, we do have a lot of different notes to shoot. One there, one there. Risky, but I'm actually going to just move her out of cover so that she can throw another grenade on this guy for guaranteed damage, and that'll also shred his armor, and then we can finish him off and get a focus stack on our Templar.
I will tear you apart!
Says as the fire stops. Alright, so we got one more attackable node here. We've got the big target here. We've got like three we can shoot this turn. So we can kind of do a little bit of a regroup turn. But just so we're clear, I'm not going to stop being sad about Fournier. So the first question is, how far do we want the Templar to push up? Because really, there's probably one more pod on the map. I think we're gonna go here. It's pretty unlikely there's another pod over in this corner. We can probably open this door to activate the last pod, and then he can shoot that. I'm just so upset by losing Fournier.
I'm going!
We've got another one there. Alright, so she can see those two. She can't see that one yet.
Let's
do this. Alright, that's one only you can see.
I'm trusting you here.
Got that one. You got that one. And then we really don't want to trigger any more pops with him.
Scanning.
So we've got plenty of time to move forward very cautiously from here. Now you can see this one, I guess? Okay, good to know.
I can handle that.
So nothing there, so we'll want to reload with her. And then we'll want to probably push up on this corner. Or, no, actually I like this door better. Just through this door to here, so we can pull the Templar back a little bit. or keep pushing them forward. What could go wrong?
We're not picking up any more of those relays. That's all the time we're going to get, Commander.
Heading there now.
5 turns is a lot. Sniper
move,
here.
Move, move.
Reload you.
Let's rock.
And sniper here.
Finally.
Reload.
I'm ready.
Oh, it was a free reload. Shouldn't have actually done that. Alright, so we do have a full turn to go for,
heading to that location.
A full door breach here, where we stack everyone up on the door. Then blow the hell out of it.
Copy that.
Actually,
moving to position.
Let's get just snipers on both sides.
Solid copy.
Wow, if that little detour around there had revealed something, I would have been very sad.
Solid copy.
Solid copy. Sounds gross.
No one gets by me.
What? Open the door.
We've got eyes on the objective.
That's a confirmed visual on the transmitter. Plant the X4 charges before they can cut it off from the network.
All right. So go ahead and give him move there. And move there.
Get in there now.
So, they really like hiding a pod directly behind the objective, so we'll probably stack up some overwatches and go set the charge next turn when we have a full set of moves available.
What's over
Hopefully
there?
This doesn't reveal anyone.
No problem, boss.
Alright, and then just overwatches.
Moving to overwatch.
Maintaining this area.
Long on overwatch.
Affirmative. Covering now.
I'm on it.
See, there we go.
I will improve at any cost.
I got nothing.
It's still moving.
Need to find some new cover.
Nice. At least we got one hit. Alright, well, we've got a lot of resources left at this stage.
Moving!
So I like starting with... Does this really hit all four of them? It does. That's great.
This is for you!
This is to avenge Fournier. Man, we also... We just spent multiple things upgrading him at the start of this mission, and then he died horribly. That's sad. I mean, you can just kill all these guys single-handedly. What was that?
Not good. It's dead. It has to be dead.
Uh, hit him with shotgun.
Not too shabby.
We're not picking up any other contacts. Get those charges deployed.
I'm on it, Command. Can you just see how disheartened I am by the loss of a troop, regardless of how successful the meeting is, the mission is? Rest in peace, 48.
Following today's attack by the criminal organization XCOM, all citizens are advised to prepare for intermittent power failure throughout the city. Advent assures us that they will have the power grid restored quickly.
I hope you're ready to be famous.
Oh, that's inappropriate. Reflect, invert, deep focus. Yeah, definitely want the deep focus. You're all we got now. At least he's a genius. 14 AP already. Well, maybe you'll stick with hanging out with Grenadiers.
Hello, Commander.
All right. So, talking a little strategy layer here. So, was thinking a bit about it. We've got some projects for...
This will prove to be an important step forward.
We're making some good progress on the plot stuff and dealing with the Avatar project. We've got a covert op. We're building a radio relay so that we can start pushing outward. 3 days... So I was about to start researching Illyrium, because I think we're actually at the point where we want to take some time off to build some, to start making progress towards our really high-level tech. But the fact that this is inspired, and we could definitely use some extra intel, means I'm happy to spend 3 days on this.
Having developed a greater understanding of
clearing debris here, comms in 4 days.
We can now construct a facility designed specifically to analyze any materials we recover related to their
Building we begin immediately. A radio relay.
Course for West Africa.
And then we'll be able to make contact over here in 4 days once everything finishes up.
Just as you will adapt your campaigns to fuel the resistance. So too shall I adapt to satisfy the claim my reward.
Well,
the chosen aren't afraid to resort.
Definitely
to
don't want to spend 10 days on that thing I didn't care about.
We need to work to prevent these attacks before they catch up with us.
Our work is proceeding as expected, Commander. I'll direct our efforts towards the.
Yeah, I was actually going. One of the things I was talking about was going to talk about was. Making good progress on the Avatar project. We're getting to the point where we're going to start looking at another high-level push for big high-level tech. But the Assassin is getting a lot of knowledge on us, so I think after we finish up our sabotage covert actions, we're going to want to start pushing towards hunting down the Assassin and killing her. Hey guys, it's a radio. Bomb squad. So experimental grenade and weapon. So we're working on a spark, and I do want skull mining at some point. We don't have anyone who can use heavy weapons just yet. We'll need a war suit for that, which we don't have. Oh, exosuit. But at the very least, I'm not sure how many Illyrium cores we have, but I think it's a lot. I'm pretty on board with
Hello, Commander.
just throwing out a couple grenades to...
I've been digging through some of the old data files Central has been holding onto since before the war. I keep running across notes scrawled in English and what looks like broken German. I should probably ask them.
Acid grenade. Gas grenade. I'm sure one more just for funsies. Incendiary grenade. So we can get some use out of those if we feel like it. So we're probably going to make contact next. So we're not likely to do... Let's fly over to the black market. We didn't prevent it from being closed, so I'd actually kind of like to unload any inventory we're not planning on using right now. No interests. Definitely not selling any alloys or Illyrium. We've got 3 cores left. So, I think everything we've completed the autopsies on, we're pretty comfortable just unloading. Do need stun lancers for certain types of armor. I think we can just unload a lot of this nonsense. I just don't want to be caught super short on supplies with a closed black market. Or even a little bit short of supplies with a closed black market, which is arguably worse. Do you want to do shield bearer autopsy? Aye.
Market is open.
Anything we want to buy? Do we have a lot of intel right now? Definitely don't care about either of these. Yeah, I think I'm... Oh, the alloys and the Illyrium are both tempting, but we won't need them for a little bit. So let's hold on to our intel for building out our network at the moment. So let's just swing over here, gain intel for like a day while we wait for our relays to finish up, and then we can go establish content. Well, we've got a project that's going to do some damage to... Oh, okay. That was it. Cool, so that is a lot
some
more comfortable breathing
room. A little
room.
Worse for wear after that last covert action,
these
but
guys are both ready
to
promote.
Rest, they'll be fine.
Alright. So, just looking quickly for anything else that leaps out. Can do some recruiting. Don't really want approved cannons. Yeah, I really like hunting the Chosen Assassin here. Yeah, I'd like to send a captain so we don't get anyone captured. I really want to keep our last bond pair together. So I'll go ahead and send there. Lieutenant plus. Let's give... No, actually, I take that back. Let's send this pair out, since, but we don't actually need a captain for this. We just need a lieutenant and a sergeant. And then we can send out... Maybe our low-level bond pair? That sounds good to me. Well, and I just kind of want everyone around right now. I'm just so nervous after losing a troop. Alright, who wants the health? Diamond wants the health. Let's give her a day off. and lower level sharpshooter. All right, let's do it.
Covert is our specialty. Let's just hope your people can keep up.
So we're... Wait. Oh, we can't do that because we have no supplies.
Resistance communications facility now operational.
Alright, sweet. So that gives us extra contacts. And then we can upgrade it for another comm station, and we could staff an engineer here for another comm station. We've got a ton of power. And we do have an engineer available to start excavating here. We'll probably staff someone in comms in a little bit, but we would like to finish everything else up first. So now we can make contact. We have already made contact here. Alright, so we've got two steps to this facility and two steps to this facility.
Beyond the resistance, and soon the whole world will be watching.
Man, I do not care about that continent bonus. It doesn't look like... Oh, this facility has got three dots of progress, so we want to go here. And we will make contact.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity.
Yeah, I can just get more anytime we want.
We can't establish any contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Attempting to establish local regional contact.
Alright, so that gave us a chunk of supplies. We do need a shadow chamber at some point, but I feel like we're doing okay on plot, and I'm a little scared about tactics right now. I think it's finally time to build an infirmary. And we've got an engineer there. So we've got an open engineer. We can just sign there for the time being. Still, I'm pretty happy to be spending our supplies on that. We could send someone over to help clear the alien debris. That's probably more valuable than taking 3 days off of our covert ops. Alright, what are we worried about? What are we hoping for? Got a decent team together for the next mission, but if we were to get two right in a row, we'd be looking down the roster a little ways. Let's take a quick look at the training center. He could easily pick up another ability. She's got 43 AP to spend. We've just been leveling her up on missions without doing anything. And then Wildman, our new grenadier, has a bunch of points.
From some clown calling himself Van.
Wouldn't mind giving him some blast padding just like to try and recruit, keep him alive. For. Yeah, let's go for it. Just, we need a high-level grenadier. Alright, and we're making progress on Illyria. That's fine, we're coming for a facility. We'll be there in a minute.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project.
Yeah, I know.
If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Commander, the aliens aren't slowing down. They've already got multiple facilities operating across the globe. We're running out of
time. It looks scary, but once you start hitting these facilities, you can clear out a lot of progress really quickly. So we are two steps away from that facility. Two steps away from this facility.
Commander, will need to completely scan this region before we can establish contact with the local resistance.
Got a spark coming.
I'd advise we stick around and finish the job, but
yeah,
the choice
that's fine.
Is yours.
They knew what they were getting themselves into when they joined up with your resistance.
All right, got a spark.
The others don't have mercy to spare for anyone.
The Chosen are gonna do whatever it takes to get to you, Commander. Even if that means wiping out entire camps of Resistance supporters. We're their only line of defense.
I feel like there might have been some VO there I missed, which makes me sad. Oh, and of course I sold all of my Advent Trooper corpses, and now I need them. Alright, well, Blue Screen Protocol and Skull Mining are both super good. Which do I want to do first? Let's get our hack on.
Sounds good, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
We're going to have to be carrying that around for a while anyways, so might as well make it worth our while.
Their suffering is needless, but they have spurned the Elder's Office of Peace for the last time.
Alright, we've got a Warlock and a Retaliation mission. Let's
setting
go take care of it.
For East Africa.
Commander Tigan and Shen aren't going to be happy if we don't put the Skulljack to good use. We should have one of our soldiers equip it before they deploy.
I probably shouldn't read that. So I really like Bringo Reaper on this mission. Alright, got a bit of tactical thinking to do, and I've been going for a while, so this seems like a good time for a 5-minute break. So we'll just take a quick break here. And we'll be back with more XCOM in 5 minutes. Hey! And we're back with more XCOM 2. So, went ahead and outfitted the squad, gave a couple of upgrades on everyone. One thing that I did discover that is a little frustrating is that the utility items who were on the three people I sent out on the covert mission are not available, so apparently you're supposed to, like, strip items off people and change their loadouts before you send them on covert actions, which is somewhat frustrating because we're doing this mission without a mimic beacon or our poison ammo, so that's a little rough. I didn't finish the grenade selections. Can probably give a little more value scattered around there, but it's pretty unfortunate how short on items we are here. We'll actually leave 2 plasma grenades just so we've got some good cover destruction and stuff. We're also bringing our Spark unit on its first mission, so we'll see how this goes. Unfortunately, the Chosen who may show up is the Warlock, and our Templar is the only one of our 3 specialty troops who is not currently available, so we're not going to get to exploit one of his weaknesses. He is also vulnerable to high ground,
if I recall correctly. The aliens have amassed a huge force to strike one of the Resistance outposts nearby. Those people desperately need any help we can provide them.
So this may be a Chrysalid mission?
Secure the area. One of those Chosen is leading an assault on the Resistance encampment in this area. Our people are doing what they can to fight back, but we need to help protect the civilians.
And if we get
nearby
an opportunity, we could skulljack someone, but that would be,
there's a group of Resistance soldiers,
let's say, a little ambitious.
Not far from your position. Move in and help fend off the attacking alien forces.
Alright, so got a Reaper, which is always nice. Get a little bit of concealed movement forward. Wow, nothing. Alright.
Father really outdid himself, didn't he?
I've not played with Sparks, so I'm not used to them being, quirky.
Moving to designated position.
Alright, so you are not a blade master. But you have, okay, you're mostly a shotgun ranger. And don't, I'm good I'm pulling our sniper up to here. Grenadier up to here.
On my way.
And then once we get the enemy turned and some resistance soldiers firing, we'll have a little better idea of which way we're pushing forward to. But for now, we can overwatch. We don't have a Templar, so all of our overwatches are two, which is nice. Ah, Berserker.
You can never escape my sight.
Steer clear of those Berserkers. They can't do much from range, but they're lethal up close.
And a Muton. Nice. Not as nice. How could you miss that? It's like the size of a bus. I have a feeling you're going to reveal our range.
From me.
Oh, Jesus.
There is nowhere to hide.
Well, that's a rough start to our day. Yeah, like, any help you guys have to offer would be great. I mean, that's probably helping. Okay, and that's the later area we're pushing towards, so these guys will just clear out all the aliens before we can even get there. And we'll be busy trying not to die to holy shit berserkers. Alright. So, you've got Shredder. That's cool. Can equip and fire heavy weapons. Oh, we should have built a heavy weapon. Immune to poison and fire. Remote hacking. Alright, so we're mostly going to want to use absolutely everything we have available. So, can start off with lightning hands here. And then you could move up and flashbang would not be a terrible idea. Can you hit two with anything? Because that'd be pretty great.
A delicate placement.
It really is, but I think it's going to do a lot of good for us. We're spreading our damage a little with the hope that we get to take out everything. So, what's overdrive do? Take three actions this turn and no action is ending. So we're definitely happy to overdrive you right off the bat. And then you're just gonna fire at whatever's the highest percentage until you're out of actions. Probably. Can you see? Yeah, you can see absolutely everything. And have pretty good shots on most of it. Alright. So, Spark. Oh, but it decreases the chances every time. So at the very least, we get to take one more shot, and then maybe use a rocket to finish these guys off. Oh, rocket is... Oh, never mind, there we go. Confusing how this is working. Alright, well, we'll figure that out. So our ranger is still concealed. getting to the point where these guys are mostly dead, but we haven't killed a single thing yet, actually. How much damage does your rocket deal? 4 to 7. So we could get a guaranteed kill on either of these guys. And then we could also get another guaranteed kill with Jolt. So, Sniper. Definitely like you taking a shot on the high health thing here. Alright, and then we've got four actions left. And four enemies. So I think we're not going to want to worry about keeping the Ranger in cover. Seems likely. And it's possible one of our four actions will be frostbombing this Muton in back. So can anyone possibly kill more than one? Seems pretty unlikely. Well, you're a Grenadier. Can you hit both of these guys? You can. And that's 50-50 chance to kill there. So if you do that, can you rocket anything else? Man, rockets are persnickety. So it's not actually very good to go for that kill since the rocket can clean up one of those. Large area. Doesn't do very much damage, though. So you're probably going to be better off with combat protocol. We could... So let's see. Just running through our plan if we're willing to spend a frostbomb, if we're willing to spend all of our resources. So, rocket here to kill this Muton. Rocket to kill the Berserker, combat protocol the Muton in back, shotgun this Berserker, and frostbomb the guy in back. So the other option is we do have teamwork. Which would let our Ranger stay in cover. And we could take a 91 on one of these, or spend a grenade. Alright, well, you basically can't do anything else, so we're just gonna rocket this Muton in back. We're going to want you to combat protocol this Berserker. Yeah, I think we're on the Frostbomb plan. Which leaves us... Well, Frostbombs weren't even that good against the Chosen. Run up to here, and you're attacking from concealment, so you've got a nice little bonus. And yeah, so that's a guaranteed kill.
You can't handle me! Spotted!
Alright. And then all that leaves is frostbombing this Muton, which we can do without moving it all forward to... Oh, shit! Misclicked. I think I missed the Muton entirely.
They run like dogs.
Alright, so that's unfortunate because it's one more Muton on the map, but at least he didn't run up and kill us for a misclick. And he'll be hunted down by the real heroes of the Resistance. Alright, so that was a little rough. Sparky, go ahead and reload.
Such inefficient designs.
And no sign of Chosen yet. So we are pushing towards... Oh, so these guys aren't...
My life
active because there's still one member of this pod left. Remote start has never been good, ever. Oh, and we've still got vision of that Muton because of her ability, which is nice.
Heading there now.
So we can push forward here a little bit, but don't feel too much need to be too aggressive with it.
Heading out.
I do like moving the spark up here.
Stomp.
And then get the sniper on.
If you say so.
Less low ground. Alright. Is your reload free? It is not, so we'll go ahead and throw a reload on you.
Good to go.
Just an Overwatch is good here. Overwatch. Reload.
Good to go.
Reload.
Ready to engage.
I feel almost like this sort of mission is bugged out right now. Because the Resistance attacks and the aliens don't. So I could just, like, hang back here and let them kill all the Mutons.
Within range of your position. Sensors indicate hostile forces are closing in fast. We need to get in there before the aliens slaughter those people.
I will go.
Alright, so still no sign of anyone. Got this Muton hunkering out here, which probably means there's more over in that area. So I think because we've got Dragonova, we can push up a little more aggressively, maybe even take some yellow moves.
I'm compelled.
Not that there's necessarily any reason to do that, which is confusing. Alright, so we want you in good cover with open sight lines.
Got it. Getting it done.
And as shotgun, we want you to be close to the front.
Got it covered.
I'll watch closely.
Probably should have reloaded her, but I don't think it matters too much. Aliens doing nothing. Resistance murdering aliens. Man, they're just getting a lot of crits there. Alright, another Berserker.
Heading out.
Alright, so you've got the location of two more pods.
Moving as ordered.
And still. So the Berserker was out here. I feel pretty silly about the fact that I don't think there's actually any value in us pushing forward.
I'm all over it.
Yeah, this mission type just feels kind of buggy right now. Doesn't really work.
Here I come! Affirmative.
Jolt.
I'm on the move. Rock and roll.
So you can reload. We haven't had an Overwatch yet, so we can just reload everyone. To make sure that this will be the turn where we'd actually get Overwatches.
Covering now.
Sounds like a job for a turret.
There we go.
I know where you are.
This is a slightly scarier pod. Pod of three instead of two. And it looks like Dragonova will get exposed.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
Wow, a lot of misses. Just shooting it from a million miles away. Okay, we'll take the ones on this side, you take the ones on that side. Oh, there is another Berserker over there. Man, that is a lot of Berserkers. So, I like you running up and shotgunning, and then potentially your friend can, well, do we actually want to save your... Who do you have vision of? Vision of everyone, and if we can pull up cover... Like, those are really good grenades if someone has grenades. And any kind of remote start over there, Dragonova? Nope. Alright. So I think I like.
Sure thing.
Move up. Grenade these guys in their cover.
Surprise!
Hey, I learned about these grenades from you guys, by the way.
I'll comply for now.
Okay. That was not good. On the other hand, that Berserker will probably just kill civilians, which is, you know, morally complicated, admittedly. Alright, so this is not actually that likely to be a kill. Alright, so this is getting a little worse. Berserker don't want this Berserker to take a turn on us, and he's got a ton of health. Do we have any stuns or CC available? Breakthrough. Oh, yeah. So this would actually be a pretty good lightning dance here, potentially. Chance to kill it. And you're flanked. And we've only got three actions left. And there's a bunch of mutons over on our left side. Alright, it's definitely better to kill one of these dudes. Well, oh my god, life is a nightmare. This is just going to be a really bad turn. So I think flashbanging these two guys is actually going to be a good use of our time. So, oh yeah, this is perfect. We pistol here. That's only one action left, so you can't necessarily flashbang. Could incendiary. We do have two guys grouped up here, which is a problem for those grenades. Could you flashbang both of these guys? No, not really. You could set them on fire. Can't kill either of these, and you're in a place where you're likely to get can you get to somewhere where you have a nice shot on this guy? Oh, you can just blow up his car, can't you? Car but that one? Yes, you can blow up every car but that one. Ugh. You can flashbang one but not the other. Kill the other? Probably not.
Moving to designated position.
It's a 40% crit, and a reasonable chance of killing it without the crit.
Get it together!
So that's probably the best bet. Well, this is an 82. And that's basically all you can do. This is a little better.
I definitely got that one.
Oh, man, this fight has gone poorly. even a crit would not kill. This is better, I assume. Alright. Oh, you had a hollow target. We probably could have taken advantage of that.
The resistance team is in the clear. They're moving to help the other survivors.
Okay. Well, if mutons don't kill me this turn, you guys will probably kill them and we'll be in good shape. One civilian.
Commander, Advent isn't backing off. They've got units in the AO that are ignoring our forces just to get a better shot at the civilians.
Yep.
Take those bastards down.
That is rough. Oh, that is a likely kill.
Soldiers through a lot. They'll need time to deal with these issues when we get back.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
You cannot die.
This has way more pods than I expected. I guess that's the balance for all these resistance troops, so I should have played this way more cautiously. I just kind of could have sat back forever and let these guys clear it out, and chose to push up and do stuff instead, and was very badly punished for it. So there's two Berserkers and three Mutons on the map, I believe. Man, we're losing soldiers two missions in a row. It's pretty rough. Starts.
I go where you tell me.
The time for hiding is over.
Yeah, not quite. But now you can blow that up? We could have saved someone's life if you could have blown that up next turn, last turn. So let's... you're gonna use your overdrive again.
Physical exertion outpoint.
Alright. Man, your aim sucks. And so there's nothing close to that car. Where is the third muton? That's worrying.
Known to
It's only you two, huh? Off this guy. Berserkers are just having themselves a party inside. Oh, and there's that last muton. Wait, did that resistance trooper just survive a hit for 5 damage? Kill the muton over on the side first, but these civvies have done a good job of... Oh, they're just gonna kill the faceless without ever doing anything? That's nice. Faceless is down, we've just got the two berserkers upstairs. That'll probably kill two more civilians, but what are you gonna do? Man, it is very random what you can and cannot remote start at any given moment. Wouldn't mind going and picking up this loot before it expires. It's a little hard to justify that when there's berserkers killing civilians. So are any of the berserkers on the ground floor? It doesn't look like we can get to them. So we could take a shot there, get holo targeting. We could also soften it up and remove its armor. We do need to get her over to the berserkers eventually.
Let's move already!
So just a little bit short there. So, I mean, you're honestly on go either pick up the loot or just get holo targeting. You're not going to be super valuable either way right now. right, we do need to figure out how we're actually killing this thing. Spending way too many resources, I assume? That'll bring it up to 73. Alright, let's just do some things.
I didn't get through to the meat.
Not you. You. Alright. Don't have run and gun. I was kind of counting on that. So we have a combat protocol. Man, we can't kill one muton. Left is Berserkers.
Rolling.
So we can just push up here
and
throw down an overwatch. Alright, so they're both right up here on this one top floor. This one's almost dead, this one's still at full health. And that is probably where it... we're not super close to failing the mission. Yeah, we're fine. We could let them kill, what, three more civilians and still succeed? Obviously, saving more is better, but... We should have had Lebedev pick that up instead of overwatching, our bad. Alright, so you can run in here and appraise us in this situation. Good job, Mr. Spark. Man, 0% crit. That's amazing. No one else could get inside of these. So, that may not be a great idea. I'm kind of curious about, can I get a grenade that will drop these guys through the floor? Well, I could get... it's not looking super like it. Probably have to give one of these guys an attack. I don't have a combat protocol left.
Give me time to reload.
All right. Man, there's just no good ways up to where they are. Gonna have to let these guys kill more civilians. Can we get a flashbang?
Okay, I'll go.
Do flashbangs make these guys useless? Alright, so that...
Flash out.
I don't know if this works, but it's worth a try. Alright. Who has two moves left? You have zero target previews anywhere. What? Can you get... So if you get to here, they still can't see you. But then you're in range to do something next turn. And then can put the ranger up there as well. Let these guys maybe kill our mech, maybe kill more civs.
Tired of waiting around.
I mean, I'm not going to miss this mech much. She's not very good.
I stalk my prey. I am trusting you.
Alright. Today we learned that, disorientation does not bother Berserkers very much. So if we, still had a Grenadier, he could give our, shotgunner two shots, but, he died horribly. So that's unfortunate. So we'll just have to rely on these guys to do our job for us. Oh, if you block the doorway, I would have been very upset with you. Yeah, I guess we just killed this guy. I'm not going to feel good about it, though, after losing our another troop. Alright, Sparky, what do you got? Classic 90% to hit at point blank. Miss Hollow targeting. Can you get anywhere with sight? You cannot see it from here. That is madness. Alright. Alright, well, go ahead and take your shot and we'll finish it off with Julia. Or not Julia, because Julia's on a covert action vacation. Who do we actually need to kill on the most? Probably still a ranger.
Let's move already!
Also, you know, you get to avenge your partner, so that'll be good.
You've secured the remaining civilians, and there are no other hostile.
Another mission with the soldier death.
Good work out there.
Years of peace and
can't keep it up at this rate.
Will not be undone by the reckless actions of a few misguided dissidents today. We stand with the elders. Trust in their wisdom, and we shall.
Spark made the most attacks. None of them did anything. But, yep, should have just hung back and let the resistance kill aliens for us.
There's even one Reaper left standing. You can bet they're still in the fight. Finger on the trigger.
Yeah, not having run and gun was rough that mission. And, as got a sharpshooter with face off, nice. Yeah, hello to you too. Alright. Man, roster's looking a little thin. Yeah, we've basically got the Lebedevs as our top-level pair. Our only good bond baits left. We've got three captains, three lieutenants, so we can still field one reasonably high-level squad. We should actually look for an opportunity to do a good training mission at some point here.
Beyond what their eyes can show them.
If we can find a relatively easy mission. Not now. We want to finish making contact
with Chile. Setting course for the Chilean Control District.
Mm.
giants of the Earth.
We've managed to track the chosen hunter to this region.
Located.
All right, so...
Word of your exploits spreads among the desperate masses of humanity.
So it'd be, I think, 120 intel to get to this next area. Yeah, so we'll need some intel to do that, or to some supplies to build a radio relay. Let's go ahead and get that intel.
Avenger plotting new course.
We'll be detouring to pick up supplies, and then probably sidetrack three more times from there, but... This is the most productive of the things available to us so far. Alright. And I do really want... But we do still have our spark, so let's go ahead and throw down a couple experimental heavy weapons. Advanced explosives. Huh. Flamethrower, not my favorite. We've got four Lyrian cores, so I'll spend... Oh, we've got one left? Alright, I'll hold off for a time. And then... Oh, let's see. Could get a spider suit. Let's just get a little straight protocol going on.
We're finished, Commander.
We don't really need this engineer as much, so we can go ahead and put them on. We're at max comms. Could just start clearing some alien debris. Exposed power coil. Pretty good on power for the time being. We can excavate one more spot here.
Message for you.
Alright. I think we have yet to fail a mission, despite it is unfortunate, some pretty unfortunate
that your recent efforts have proven
mediocre.
To be so mediocre.
We've succeeded every mission, and we're gonna take care of the progress. We knocked off two with that covert op, and we're getting towards
now, for your secrets flow to me as easily as the Elder's blessed power.
Increased risk on coverts. Alright. Black market closed. No concealment. Ugh, yeah. A lot of medium bad, but nothing totally unacceptable. I refuse to accept that I am going to keep losing troops. Yep, this feels like the right three to keep for the time being. Should get some more slots here at some point. Yeah, and we are willing to leave behind this intel to go get the supplies. We've been very short on them.
Commander, we're picking up an emergency transponder signal. It looks like the last team we deployed was ambushed on their covert action.
Okay, so never played this before. One nice little bit of good news here. So there is lost and a chosen. One little bit of good news is these guys have all the super good equipment that we were unable to use in the last mission. So let's go ahead and take a look at how this works. It's loading. Do we just start off with them? We did send three people, which is nice. Alright. So we need
You've
to get
got
to
no
here.
Time to waste. Break cover and move to the extraction point on the double.
Alright, so we're just running for it. And there's the Lost and maybe a Chosen? It's unclear. So, only one of us has cover. And we've got Templar, Ranger, Sniper. Well, this will be interesting.
Position confirmed.
So I would assume we actually,
Understood.
There's no
Move
visible
now.
Timer, so I don't think we actually have a good reason to,
Let's do this.
Push forward here.
My senses are...
I'm on it!
I'm glad we have, like, some troops who are good against the Lost between Shotgunner and Sharpshooter.
They've called
Raid 1, your team is compromised. We're picking up Advent response forces inbound on your position.
Alright, well... The biggest thing I'm nervous about here is purifiers,
we're on target position now.
Which could explode and mess with us.
Moving to Overwatch.
I think pistol Overwatch is it might actually be better here, just to avoid the range penalties.
Come get some.
I'll keep it under watch.
No purifier, Captain Trooper. Okay, this is a very dealable pod.
So-called peacekeepers.
Position compromised.
So-called peacekeepers. The captain just immediately dies, and...
Here I come!
Alright, so I assume we can just pistol you. Yep. Good, I was a little worried that was going to kill you, because then we want your focus. And then pull you back to here. So, and then reload an Overwatch with the Ranger.
Let's do this.
And we're good to push forward. Lost Swarm. Man, two pistol users is pretty great for a mission with the Lost, especially with our highly upgraded pistols.
No problem, boss. Got it covered. Affirmative. Covering now.
I will sense any disturbance.
Alright, so there's the Lost Swarm. Only five of them, it looks like. Did not see any dashers. Alright, and we're pushing directly through that building? Now, this is a bit of a long walk. Alright, so we actually see the Lost there? Okay. So I guess it's slightly... Oh, cost one focus. So I guess we could just have you use a pistol shot just for funsies.
We must not
this is slightly
fail.
Better than overwatching.
Scanning.
And then overwatch Overwatch. There and there. Maybe we're not even supposed to overwatch on the shotgun. Just because ammo is good. We haven't hit a lost yet, which is not ideal.
I can handle that.
So let's just have you kill a bunch of these guys.
Did you see that one? Well, how about that?
And these five are the only ones currently on the map.
Impressed yet? Running dry on ammo.
So there's one more back there if we'll want to kill with someone else if possible.
Need a resupply.
Get a reload on her.
Tired of waiting around.
All right, can we get vision on him? There we go. Come on. No, it's definitely not worth using a grenade. I guess we just double pistol
Overwatch
and maybe take one damage. Alright.
Who's keeping score?
Sweet. Still on full ammo. And we just want to push through this gate here.
I'm going.
I think I like not using Overwatch on the Ranger. Just way better to run up and take high percentage shots. So you can just
hold
her with her.
Holding.
So there are some number of advent here. We don't have Shredder, but it is straight up 3-on-1, which should be okay. I imagine we can actually just, like, shotgun it once, rend it, and that'll be enough. But another pot of one is still... Alright. 54. 44. Getting a rend on that guy sounds not ideal. Could grenade him. Doesn't sound like a great use of time. What are the odds this just kills it instantly? Not too bad.
Not too shabby.
Alright, so you have got... You could vault for a pretty close to guaranteed kill. Or a, you know, good chance at a kill. I think I like just take the 54 to not spend our focus.
Missed the target!
And I actually like, even though this could activate one more, we have the parry up, and we're up two focus because we're plus one instead of minus one relative to using the Volt. And it's 100% chance to kill. PCS conditioning. I look forward to giving that to someone. Alright, Lost Swarm incoming. Don't really want to move him up super far.
Whatever you say.
Would be nice to eventually get our sniper on some high ground. We're pushing forward. There's not that much value in, like, trying to hold any sort of position.
Maintaining this area.
And reload.
It's killing time.
Yeah. It looks like it's 5 of them again, pretty far away. Don't know if we have more Advent incoming or not.
No problem, boss.
Yeah, we don't need to take that shot.
Let's do this. On Overwatch.
No one will slip past.
Hunker, because I don't want you to spend ammo on medium Overwatch shots. But you guys don't have that.
Refocusing.
How many is that now?
Oh, nice promotion.
Here I come.
So one down. We can see 2 and 3 here. But there's still 2 around somewhere that we can't see right now.
You see that?
So this is guaranteed not to kill.
Seems doable.
Alright, so that gives you... There's one more in there.
Did you see that one?
So we killed 3, we know one's in there, and that leaves 1.
No one gets by.
We can just overwatch to attempt to deal with the rest. By which I mean the remaining 2. A little. Oh, I was going to say an inefficient damage spread, but it actually worked well. Perfect. Alright, so continuing to push, could be one more Advent trooper or something.
I can handle that. Move already.
In general, think we're... Could actually be... Nope.
I can do
this
that.
Click. Not a bad one, but...
Advent has come.
You know that part where I said not a bad one? Not necessarily true. So... Could use run and gun to kill him. I think that's better than our mimic beacon.
Call it aft. I'm going.
Oh, lost swarm. Forgot about that.
Finally.
So we are a little short of getting to the safe zone this
time.
Whatever
you say. Tired of waiting around.
Moving to Overwatch. Scanning.
Alright. Oh, that's a cool effect when you run through those guys. Yeah, we definitely don't want to try and go over there and kill those guys. We just want to get out this turn.
Location confirmed.
So, weirdly, getting ambushed was upside this mission. In that it gave us a mission on which we took no wounds and got 2 promotions. So that's kind of funny.
Power guides me. I'm out.
Let's
members of Wraith 1 have been successfully evac'd.
Flawless. Wraith 1. I like that. Your main squad is Menace 1, so your covert action squad is Wraith 1.
I'm glad to see our troops finding success in the field. It's good for the entire crew's morale.
I'm pretty into, Bladestorm. Alright. And we've got our other, sniper spec'd heavily into, Gunslinger, so I'll try his sniper over here. Oh, and these guys, can bond. Can they? Yeah, so, Julia... Oh, wait, it's actually a different one than I thought. It's, So could I do any? Okay, so I could bond Diamond and Charlie or Lockdown and Charlie? Or Diamond and Lockdown? Okay, interesting. I'll have to think about that a little bit. The mighty 1 HP.
Our people seem to work well together, Commander.
Gained XP, gained health, negated risk of soldier capture.
Our intel on the Chosen is getting more detailed every day.
Keep this up, Commander, and we might just make you an honorary Reaper.
Nice, got some extra Reaper. New volunteer orders. New covert actions available.
My people are up for some additional work if you've got any orders for us, Commander.
Chance at a resistance soldier. I mean, those guys are, as we have established, we do not have a major to finish this one off.
Share some new information on the Chosen.
Okay, but we've got a new... I think I'll, like, just, continuing to jam, Reduce Avatar Project. Let's go get some resources first, because 25 resources to avoid a capture is definitely worth it. I just like having some breathing room to not lose the game, mostly. Mox is just a little too low level, so we've been having trouble getting him leveled up, so that's definitely a good choice. And then we could also send Wildman. Yeah, let's get these two leveled up. And I do want to hunt the Chosen level 3 once we get the chance, but... Alright, let's actually see who's hanging out together and how we like it. Charlie Hunt and Julia Rubble.
Tell you otherwise, but this is the true voice of the Resistance, bringing you the real news about the latest victory over the invaders.
No, I think I'm in for this one. Day,
and XCOM is making that happen.
I don't blame Shen for wanting to keep an eye on Tigan, but at this point...
They've been on 18 missions together. It seems... appropriate. Don't have enough power for this. But we could. So we could get the continent bonus for more relays. Can we upgrade this power relay? 80. And then the shadow chamber is 150. How much do we actually need the shadow chamber? I mean, I don't want to pause our research for the plot stuff yet. We will want it eventually. Should consider this by the end of the month, but we don't need it now. Additional comm station upgrades that. I don't know, let's finish off this supply drop.
Commander, the infirmary can be used to improve the recovery process of our wounded soldiers. And over time, they'll also recuperate from any negative conditions they've picked up in combat. We can also speed up the process through therapy if needed.
Alright, so a lot of people tired, no one injured. Our Templar is afraid of missed shots. We've got enough of a squad that I'm okay taking our Templar off duty for a couple days, I think. If I can remember where everything is. 5 days. Do we have any available engineers? Yes. We have a ton of available engineers. So we could just clear all the debris for supplies. It's kind of nice. I think I like that. We might need to pull someone off for comms eventually. Or we probably will need to pull someone off for comms eventually, but... got a number of abilities we could purchase here. We should consider those before the next mission. Finish picking up supplies. Alright. So...
I have already learned a great deal about your methods,
got Commander. This intel and a scientist.
Soon, I will reclaim
Let's get the intel.
You and all that you have taken from the Elders.
If I can't get you directly, Commander...
Yeah, I just... I think it's monthly time income is not that big a deal.
...friend of yours, poking around out here.
These Chosen are constantly hunting us.
Yeah, we're on our way. We've got a covert action in the works. We're on our way to a really good facility.
We'll need to pay close attention to each one as they gain more information about our plans. Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
I've made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
All right, so this gives us our top-level tech. Plasma rifle is a little bit faster, and I broadly think the offensive upgrades are more important than the defensive, but we've been losing a lot of people, and this is just a complete squad-wide upgrade.
I will send word as soon as we have something of note.
I think it's worth spending the better part of a month on it.
I will spread fear across this world. So, all will know what lies ahead.
Trying to hunt you
Our
down.
Our friends in the Resistance are paying a heavy price with the Chosen running loose. We should do what we can to take
right,
them
we
down
need to make contact
before they
over
hit
here.
Again.
120. I thought we just got enough. We need comms. So, sorry, gonna pull back off for a minute and staff you. Under resistance comms. And then we get to... it's a... contact with new regions made instantly. That's kind of cool. can go ahead and set up a radio relay there and then start moving our way back up.
Attempting to establish local regional contact.
Alright, and that feels like a good time to call this stream for the evening. Still don't think we've failed a mission yet on this campaign, which is nice. I feel like we've got a really good build as far as delaying the Avatar project goes. We haven't put a ton of resources into it, but we've got a couple of these covert actions keeping our heads above water, and we're about to knock out a pretty high-value facility. But the loss of a couple soldiers is really rough, losing two of our high-level troops. We are up to four captains, so we are close to a major, and it is possible even that we could get a major to be able to hunt down the Chosen immediately after this sabotage mission. Anyways, so call it a night with that guerrilla tactics mission in the chamber, but thanks to everyone for watching, and have a good night, everyone.